So, okay. Good morning to everyone. Today we will see about the topic that's name is KMP algorithm, or the or we can say this as the Knuth Morris Pratt algorithm. The name is Knuth Morris Pratt algorithm. Now, before this starting this KMP algorithm, we will know what KMP algorithm does. KMP algorithm is used for pattern matching. KMP algorithm is basically used for what? It is used for pattern matching. That means there will be a string present or the string will be given. And a pattern will be also given here. We have to check that the pattern which is given is present in the string or not. So there will be a string given and a pattern will be given. We have to check that the pattern is present in the string or not. This is basically the Knuth Morris Pratt algorithm does. Now, if it finds that the pattern is present in the string, then what we have to do? We have to find out its index. Its index will be find out. So, KMP algorithm does this, but basically this string matching, for this string matching, there is also some basic algorithm present. KMP algorithm is used for string matching, that the pattern is present in the string or not. We have to check, and if it is present, then it will return the index. But before starting the KMP algorithm, we will say that there is some basic algorithm also present there, that which find that the pattern is present in the string or not. Some basic algorithm is present for that also. But due to some drawbacks of this algorithm, we use the KMP algorithm. So before starting the KMP algorithm, we will see that what is that disadvantage of the basics algorithm and what is the drawbacks for it. And after the drawbacks, what changes has done by Knuth Morris Pratt to efficiently do this algorithm, efficiently working of this algorithm for string matching. So the basic our algorithm, which is used for the string matching, that is naive-Bayes algorithm. And some disadvantages present this naive-Bayes algorithm. For this reason, KMP algorithm is used. But both this algorithm is what? Both this algorithm does the string matching. That the pattern is present in the string or not. They will check it. So first, let's start our basic algorithm. So our basic algorithm, you see, I have taken a string. That's what I am saying, that there will be a string and a pattern. We have to check that the pattern is present in the string or not. So I have taken a string and I have taken a pattern. In the string, what is the string? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. And the pattern is D, E, F. That means we have to check this DEF is present in the string or not. So how we will compare it? So first comparison will be like this, that first character, what is? It is A, and the pattern's first character is D. So that means mismatch. If there is mismatch, then we will shift this pattern, will shift to the one position right. You see, one position right, we shift it. We shifted to the one position right. You see, first, these are mismatched because in the string it is A and in the pattern it is D. So that means what? This is mismatch. So we move the our what? We move our pattern to one position right. So we move our pattern one position right. Now we will check the first elements. It, in the first, it is B and here it is D. So that means what? It is mismatch. So that means we will again move it. We will again move it. So that means now our pattern is, it is mismatch occurring. So the pattern will move one position right. You see, in the one position right, it is moved. So DEF and here it is one position right, it is moved. So we will check here now. It is what? It is C and here it is D. So that means it is also mismatch. That means what we have to do? We have to again move it to the right position. So we move it into the right position. And now one position right, when we move, then we will check that. You see, this is matching. Oh, this is matching. Then that means the second element will be checked. Now these two are also matching. Okay. Then third elements will be checked. These two are matching. So, okay, that means the pattern, it is present. The pattern which we have taken, it is present on the string. It is present on the string. So that's how we have checked that first there is mismatch. When there is mismatch, we will do what? We will shift one position right. So in the next position right, we move and see. But here is also the mismatch. So first element will, if the first element are mismatched, then we didn't have to check the other elements also. Because if the first element are same, then we will check it. So that means here it is first element mismatch. So what we will do? We'll move the pattern to one position right. So when we move one position right, the pattern, there will be C present. So C and D, there are the mismatch. So mismatch means what? Again, we will move it to one position right. So one position right, we move it. And when we move one position right, then it is what? Then it is matched. So when this first two are matched, then we will check the second elements. We will check the second elements also matched. So whenever the second elements matched, we will check the third elements. Okay, the third elements are also matched. So we will get our result that the pattern which we have taken DEF is present on the string now. That's how naive Bayes algorithm works. But this example is very much easy. We have seen that the very clearly we have find that our pattern is present in the string or not. But we will see if the size of the problem or the size of the string is large. If the size of the string increase, then how we can perform it? Then we cannot perform like this, that move the pattern like this. Instead of that, we will do what? We will use I and J here. Instead of moving this, we will use I and J here. So what we will do now, let's say this is another example. This is another example we have taken. In this example, you see what? This is our string. This is our string. A, B, C, D, A, B, C, A, B, C, D, F. This is the string present. And this is what? A, B, C, D, F. This is our pattern. Now, instead of moving the pattern, which we have done previously, you see, we have used I and J. We have used the concept I and J. So I will what? I will point to the first element. I will do what? I will point to the first element. And J, first element of the string. And J will what? J will do? J will point to the first element of the pattern. Okay. So if there is a match, if there is the match, then move J as well as I. So what we will do? If match occurs, that means matching is occurred, then we will move the J as well as I. Okay. So let's start. So this first two are matched. Okay. So what we will do? First two are matched, move I. So I will move here. The first two are matched. So I will move, I will shift to one position. And J will also do what? J will also shift one position. So B, they are matched. So if this is matched, then again check the next position. So B will move here. And after B, I will move here to C. And J is also move here now to C. So these two elements are matched. Okay. So that means they are matching. Very good. So I will do what? I will again move in this position. And J will also what? J will also move in this position. So DD, this is matching. Very good. No problem. But then after matching, I will what? I will move in this position. So now I will point here. I will what? I will point here because all the elements of this pattern and this first string elements are matched. So J will do what? J will also move here. But now the problem occurs. You see, the two elements are different. It is A and it is F. So that means two elements are different. So what we will do? What we will do? In this case, the what we will do? We will use the concept of backtracking. We will use the concept of backtracking. So that means J reached till this position, reached till this position, but it will backtrack to the first position again. So it will what? It will J will go to the backtracking to the first position. And I is what? I is already present in this position. I is present in this position. So it will also backtrack. But in this case, it will be present where? It will go to the here. Because previously what? We have started for checking from this position. So the next position, the previously from where the starting of checking has been started, its next position, it I will be backtracked. So that means we have first started from this position checking. So that means I will backtrack into this position. So that means I will now present in what? I will present over B now. So that means what? That means in M is mismatch occurring. So again, J will come what? J will backtrack to the first position. And what? I will do what? I will move into the second position of the string. Why it will move to the second position of the string? Because the first time when the checking of we started first time, we start from this position. So that means whenever mismatch will occur, from where the checking is started, from where the checking is started, its next position, I will be backtracked. Okay. So that means you see what this mismatch is occurred. We know this mismatch is occurred, but we have already checked. We have already checked these elements previously. What? During occurring, we have checked these elements previously. But again, we have to check these elements. So that is what? Because I is backtracking into the second position again. So that means these elements have already we have checked. But again, we have to check these elements. So that is what? Repetition occurring. So that means what? Wastage of time, wastage of time and wastage of occurring. So that's why we didn't, this is the drawback. We want to say this is the drawback of the what? Naive Bayes. This is the drawback of the naive Bayes algorithm. You see what problem? That means I is again backtracked here. So again, we will search from here. So again, we will search means A to B, we will check. This is mismatching. So that means I will shift here. C and A, this is mismatched. So what? It will again back again move to D. So D and A, this is what? D and A, this is mismatched. So that means what? We will not consider it. Then again, I will move here. So A and A, this is matching. Okay, this is matching. That means again, B and B, this will be matched. C and C, this will be matched. D and B, these are what? I is moved here till now. I is moved here till now. But this is what? This is the mismatching is occurred. So the mismatch is occurred here right now. So that means what? We have started checking. I is moved here till now. I is where? I is moved here till now. Yes. I is what? I is moved here till now. And J is what? J is moved here. J is moved here. So this is what? This is mismatching. So mismatching means J will backtrack to the first position. So that means J will go to this. J will go to again first position. But where will I come now? We have to know from where the checking has been started. You know that our checking has been started from this position. In the next case, the checking has been started from this position. So that means I will backtrack in what? I will backtrack into this position because A, B, B, C, C, and from this, this mismatch is occurring. So that means what? That means it will be backtracked to what? It will be backtracked. So, sorry, I have this. I will move here because this A and this A. So this A, B, B, C, C, and D, A. So I will be here and J will be here. Okay. So that means what? Mismatch is occurring. So from where the checking has started in the second time, from where the checking has started in this position, the checking is started. So I will what? Its next position, I will backtrack. So I will backtrack in this position and J will backtrack in where? J will backtrack to the beginning. J will do what? J will backtrack to the beginning. Clear, Hua? Anyone has any question? Samajh mein aaya?
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So that means what? I will what? I and J will be present. J will do what? J will always go to the first position of the pattern. There is no nothing you have to think. J will go to the first position of the pattern always when it will be backtracked. But I will do what? I will backtrack to the next position from where the checking has started. Previously, I backtrack into this position because our checking has started from this position. Then what we have done, J is here. So J backtrack to the first position. So this checking has been done. So B and A, this is mismatching. So I will move here. C and A, this is mismatching. So what? I will move here. So D and A, this is mismatching. So I will move here. And now in the second time you see from this position, from five, this, what? These are matching has been started. So AA matched, BB matched, CC matched, but DA, the mismatch is occurred. Now from where our checking is started? From this position, second time from this position, our checking is started. So that means what? Whenever the mismatch will occur, I will backtrack to the next position from where the checking has been started. So that means I will backtrack into this position. So, okay. After backtracking it, now I will present in here. So let's clear this. So I will now again. So that means you can see the same things that we have already checked. We have already checked till now, but again, we have to backtrack. That means we are again, same thing we are checking repeatedly. So this is what? This is the wastage of time and wastage of our space. So that means what? Again, B and A will be checked. So this mismatch will occur. So that means C and A, it will be checked. Mismatch will occur. So again, A and A, this will be checked. So that means A and A, this is matched. B and B, this is matched. C and C, this is matched. D and D, this is matched. And F and F, this is matched. So that means after wastage of time, we have found that this is matching. So what is naive-Bayes algorithm basically doing? It only checking that. It is doing nothing, only checking the values. But if it didn't occur, this backtracking didn't occur, then the problem doesn't happen that. So we will see that what Knut Morisprat said, that instead of this, we will do something. But before seeing this, we will see some worst case scenario. Some worst case scenario is every element we will check. This is the worst case scenario, that every element will be checked. So if, let's say, if our string like this, if our string is placed like this, that this is the worst case scenario, that in worst case scenario, what is a string is given, set A, 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 B. So 7 A's are present, then B. And the pattern is given as 3 A and B. This is given. So that means what? Our I and J will checking start. So let's say this will be matched. Okay. This will be matched. Okay. This will be matched. Okay. This will be matched. This will be mismatched. Sorry. This will be mismatched. Now, when J is positioned till now, J reached here and I is also reached here. So that means what? J will backtrack to which position? J will backtrack to which position?
Sir, A position.
Yes, J will backtrack to in this position. And I will backtrack in what position? I will backtrack.
Second position.
Yes, I will backtrack into this position. That means already we have checked till now. But again, for backtracking, we are going to the what? Going to the previous cases. That means now it will again check. So this will check, this will be checked, this will be checked. So matching is occurred. But again, when I is in this position, what? J is in this position. Again, mismatch is occurring. So that means what? In this time, where I will be backtracked? Where I will be backtracked? In this position? In this time? That
makes third place of A.
Yes. Third position. So that means if we continue this, that means what? In every position, I will be backtracked. In every position, because mismatch will occur every time. Because again, next time we will mismatch will occur, because A and B, this will be mismatched. And this time it will be, I will backtrack to fourth position. Then I will backtrack in fifth position, fourth position. That means what? Each and every element, we are backtracking to each and every element. This is the worst case scenario. This is the worst case scenario. So that means if we see that string is N and the pattern is M, if we consider the string as N and the pattern is N, so total time is taken. What the total time will be taken? Total time will be taken order of MN, because this is multiplying. This is every time this is backtracking. So what we will say, the time taken will be the order of MN. We will say the time taken will be the order of MN. So this is the worst case scenario for the naive-Bayes algorithm. Now, what Knut Morris said, Knut Morris used some techniques. Knut Morris used some techniques. So we'll see what are the techniques Knut Morris used. So Knut Morris is used what? Some technique Knut Morris used. So let's say Knut Morris said that there will be a prefix and suffix present. Prefix and suffix will be present there. So how we'll find that? Let's say this is an string. It is given, this is a pattern we have given. Now in this pattern, you see a pattern will be given and we will find the prefix and suffix from pattern. So that means there is a pattern given A, B, C, D, A, B, C. So this is a pattern given. Now, what will be the prefix? Prefix means previously. One thing's previous, prefix. And suffix means in the backside. So that means if we consider this is the our pattern, then what will be the prefix? We can say A, A, B, A, B, C, or A, B, C, D. We are doing such a prefix. Same as that, what for suffix we will see from right side. So C, next B, C, next A, B, C, next D, A, B, C, like this. You see prefix we have used A, then A, B, then A, B, C, then A, B, C, D, like this. And case of suffix, we will check from the right side. So C, then BC, then ABC, then ABC, then DA, DA, B, and C. So Knut Morris said what? The idea of the KMP is to check if there are any prefix is same as suffix. Means in a pattern, we will divide the pattern into prefix and suffix. And we will see that any prefix is matching as the suffix. Then what? Number of comparisons will be avoided. We can able to what? Avoid the number of comparison. We can able to avoid the number of comparison. Now you see, what we have done for this pattern, we have find and prefix. So this prefix is like A, B, A, B, C, A, B, C, D. Same as that for suffix, it will check from the right side. So C, B, C, A, B, C, D, A, B, C, like this. Now, if we see this, if we check this prefix and suffix, you see A, B, C and A, B, C is present in prefix and suffix both. So that means what? The comparisons will be avoided. So the idea of the KMP algorithm is what? Idea of the KMP algorithm is to check any prefix is same as the suffix or not. We have to check that any prefix is same as suffix or not. And this is for what? This is to avoid the number of comparison. You see previously, our number of comparison is very much. In the worst case scenario, you see, same thing we are doing again and again, repeating again and again. So that means that our comparison is increasing. But let's say if we find the prefix and suffix concept, then our what? Our comparison will be what? Our comparison will be avoided. So for KMP algorithm, for some KMP algorithm, we have to generate a pi table, or we can say this is the LPS table. So this is the LPS table. So how we can make this LPS table? So let's say it is given a pattern A, B, C, D, A, B, E, and A, B, F. Okay, so the pattern is given as A, B. How we will see how the LPS or pi table can be created. Now here it is given A, B, C, D, A, B, E, A, B, F. The pattern is like this. The pattern is what? The pattern is, you see, in the upper, we have mentioned the index. In the upper, we have mentioned the index. It is 1, it is 2, it is 3, it is 4, it is 5, it is 5, it is 6, it is 7, it is 8, it is 9, and it is 10. So 10 elements are present. Now from first, we started checking AB. Now you see AB have doesn't previously occurred. A and B, this is the starting of the string. This is the starting of the pattern. This is the starting of the pattern. So AB is what? AB doesn't occur previously. So that means what? we retain it as zero. CD also previously doesn't occur, so that means we write it as in the below, it is 0, 0. Now you see AB. This AB is what? Index number 1 and index number 2. This is already previously occurred, so we will write its index in the below. Now again, E is not occurring previously till now. E is not occurred. AB, here again, AB is repeating. That means in which index it is first occurred? 1 and 2. So that's why we have written below 1 and 2. And in case of F, it is not occurred previously. So that's why it is 0. So if this process should done, same as that, for in the second case you see, for in the second, if we consider for the our second pattern, if we consider our second pattern, in this also, we have to mention the index first. For the elements, we have to mention the index first. Then we will check A, B, C, D, E. This have previously not occurred. So that's why in the below, we have written it as 0, 0, 0, 0. Now, A is occurring where? First index, A is occurring. So this index number we will write below. B is occurring where? Second index. Okay. So we'll write it second. Then F is occurred where? F is occurred, not occurred till now. So that is 0. Then A is occurring where? A is previously first occurred where? From first index. So that's why we have written as 1. B is also occurred at first time. It is on the second index, it is occurred. So we have written as 2. C is occurring at third index. So we have written as 3. Same as that, for this case, if you see, for this example we have taken, if this example is we have taken, and we will also mention where the index will be mentioned. Now, first time, A is what? It is not occurred. So that's why it is 0. Then next time we are getting A. So this is A is occurring where? This A is occurring in the, we have inside below, we have written as 1 because it is previously occurred. And in which position it is occurred? In the first index. So that's why we have written as 1. BC, it doesn't occur till now. So that's why it is 0, we have written. A is occurred where? First, from 1 index. So we have written as, because in 1 index it has occurred. So we have written as 1. D, it is not occurred till now, so we have used 0. Now this 2A are 1 by 1. So that means this 2A, so they are occurring where? 1 and 2 index. So we will write it 1 and 2. B is what? B is occurring where? In the third index. So we'll write B as 3. And E is where? E is occurred till now? No, E is not occurred. So we will write it as 0. Till now, clear how we can do this? How we can do this? Okay. So that means now if there will be the many elements present, if there is the number of, let's say the our next example we take. So in this example, you see what is the string or the pattern AAAABAACD. So that means where? First A, it is on first time it is occurring, so 0. So it is 0 here. Next time A, it is what? It will be written as what? 1, because this is the first time it has occurred. So we have written this as a 1. Now, we have next time we have written it 2, because what it is, this 2 are matching with this 2, this 2 AA are matched with this 2. So that means what? This 2 are matching, we have written that as 1 and 2. Then this 3 are matching with this 3, means this 3 we can get with this 3. So that means what? We will write it as 1, 2, 3. Same as that, for this time we will write as 1 and for this as a 2. So like this, this indexing, what indexing we have done. This is basically what Knuth Morisprat said, that we generate a pi table or LPS table, or this is called the LPS table. So indexing number, we have seen the indexing number we have given. This is what KMP algorithm says. Okay, so today I will not able to start the KMP algorithm because
सर जो पैटर्न P1 है उसमें जो लास्ट में जो A आया है सर वो तो थर्ड पोजीशन पे है ना, तो उसके इंडेक्स में 1 कैसे
कौन सा
है, सर वो
कौन सा
सर पैटर्न P1
का
यस सर, सर लास्ट में सर वहां पे 1 वो सेकंड नंबर में ना आया सर, तो वहां पे 2 होना चाहिए था.
नहीं नहीं नहीं, ये जो है थर्ड वाला जो है ना, थर्ड वाला 1 जो A बोल रहा है तो फर्स्ट कहाँ आया था, ये ए को बेस में तो हम कर रहे हैं, तो इसीलिए इसका इसका क्योंकि ये फर्स्ट टाइम अपीयरिंग हुआ था, ये फर्स्ट टाइम अपीयरिंग हुआ था, उसका इंडेक्स का जो नंबर होगा वही होगा. देखो सेकंड टाइम जब ए अपीयर हुआ उसका क्या है इंडेक्स 1, थर्ड टाइम जब ए अपीयर हुआ उसका भी इंडेक्स क्या है 1, बिकॉज ये क्यों, ये फर्स्ट टाइम ऑकर्ड हुआ था, इसका रेस्पेक्टिव में हम देख रहे हैं, चेक कर रहे हैं, तो इसलिए क्या है उसका इंडेक्स नंबर जो होगा सेम एज दैट, उसका इंडेक्स नंबर भी सेम होगा. और इधर क्या है फर्स्ट वाली जगह पे P4 में देखो P4 में क्या हुआ है, P4 थोड़ा कंफ्यूज है क्योंकि हम लोग फर्स्ट क्या कर रहे हैं P4 में, फर्स्ट दिस टू वी आर चेकिंग, तो दिस टू आर चेकिंग मतलब क्या है कि ये जो फर्स्ट पोजिशन है ये फर्स्ट पोजिशन आ गया, ठीक है. देन नेक्स्ट टाइम हम क्या कर रहे हैं, नेक्स्ट टाइम हम लोग ये दो को ये दो से चेक कर रहे हैं, मतलब तीनों ए लिखे हैं, तो तीनों ए, सो हम लोगों का क्या होगा ये दो हम लोग क्या बना सकते हैं, ए ए एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो ए ए, ठीक है. हम लोग ये तीनों ए को ऐसे डिवाइड किए, दिस इज दिस टू एंड दिस टू, ऐसे डिवाइड किए, मतलब ये दो और ये दो ऐसे डिवाइड किए, तो ये दो का क्या था 1 2, तो इसलिए ये 1 2 हुआ. नेक्स्ट टाइम हम क्या किए, ये 3 एंड दिस थ्री, सो 1 2 3 एंड 1 2 3, इसीलिए हम लोग ऐसे उसको लिखे हैं, ठीक है. ओके ओके, सो this is about our total KMP algorithm. So in the next day we'll see its implementation, because today we will not able to see it. So okay, then thank you everyone, and I will share your, I will do your attendance because I have taken the screenshot. So I will update your attendance. Okay, then thank you everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.